sit, sit and bang.
It's an exciting feeling. I understand that representing my country is not a birthright, it's an honor and a privilege, and I just here to treat it as such. It's excited to, you know, don the colors again, and I'm just looking forward to the games.
What was the thought process, you know, from considering to eventually making yourself available again?
I think this coach James, he came in with no preconceived notion of me, and he didn't put me on a blacklist, so I'm here.
The composition of the squad, you know, you're going into training camps as well. How do you feel about the preparation that you all are having ahead of the World Cup qualifiers?
This is a good start. Obviously, we would have liked some games in this window. However, some of the players are in season. The college players, their school season just started. Then we have the Kenya Cordners and the Lianas and Vicky, and they're in the middle of their season. So it would have been difficult to have your core group of players together. And hopefully come October, when we do have a couple games before the tournament games, we have everyone together.
And the coach mentioned everybody starts on a fresh slate. How would that mean the competition in the squad team to want it to be you know, better?
A fresh slate, you know, he did not prejudge anyone. He allowed everyone to get an opportunity to come and prove themselves. And that's amazing. Came with an open mind, and he came being objective. And he's going to choose the best players to represent our country.
Maylee, there seems to be something different this time around. Actually, similar to the last time we would have attained some serious success at this level. Have you been able to put your finger on exactly what it is?
Well, without a doubt, I think we have a coach that is player-oriented. He's going to fight for us. We have a GPS vest for the program now, and so many other things that he's fighting behind the scenes for that we as players may not see, but I know for a fact that with conversations with him, you know, he's fighting for us, and I told him once he fight for us, we're going to go on the field and fight for him.
That coupled with, I guess, the exposure some players are getting, you know, you spoke about Vicky, Yaya out playing abroad, do you think that lends to I guess the overall goal and objective, which is to qualify for the World Cup?
Without a doubt, I think the players that played in 2014, they know in their prime, you know. Not me, but I'm still looking like a 30-year-old and running like one. So, no, it always augurs well for the program when we have players being exposed to that professional environment, that they could come back and, you know, share their knowledge and experience with the younger ones. And we're just looking forward to get the best players put together as a team and go out there and represent with, you know, honor and pride. Well, actually, you know what? I haven't played competitive football going on 5 years. This year, I got to play a few games in the UWS, which was awesome, with the Atlanta Panthers. And it definitely helped to make me know that I haven't played competitive football in a very long time. But over those years, I've always remained mentally lit. And I knew I just had to stay physically fit and as healthy as possible for when my opportunity comes again, I'll be able to grab it with both hands and represent my country with everything I have.
For the campaign in 2014-15, mainly Trinidad and Tobago, by all intents and purposes, could have considered themselves roughly around the top four in the region. It's an expanded World Cup now, which means that more teams are fighting for more spots, you know.
Right.
Where would you say we fall, and what would we have to do to ensure that we either get one of those automatic spots or one of the two player spots?
I think in 2014, that was our best chance to qualify. And looking forward to now, this is our best chance to qualify with those four automatic spots and two qualification spots. I think for us, it's just to prepare. The coaches, that the staff, the technical staff that is put together, they pay, you know, they are very meticulous and precise with the information that they have. The coach's knowledge and his application of it is awesome. And I think with him and Coach Charlie being versed in analytics, you know, analytics drive the tactics and your game plan. And the way that they break down games and the opponents that we're going to come up against is amazing. And I think that in itself augurs well for us being able to, you know, grasp what they're trying for us to do and go out there and execute it. Being able to train and they videotape the games and break down everything that we do well, that we need to do better. I mean, it's a game changer.
With the likes of yourself, some of the other senior players that we see here, Baby, etc., some of the young ones as well, you know, I guess, and this is not even the full squad that the coach would have wanted
right,
for this
correct.
Camp, you know, where do we stand in terms of the pool to get us through our qualifying campaign and then onto the World Cup in God's grace?
It's looking good. I think they're doing a good job at scouting new talent, new players who we've never seen, who've never been on the radar. There are a couple players, if it does come to fruition, I think we're going to be an exciting team, or even more exciting than the one in 2014.
Exciting times to Trinidad and Tobago if we went to football.
Correct, is right.
I must ask, you know, was there like, or is there a little, without putting it, without making that negative connotation, a little cabal in terms of, I guess, you guys, the senior ones, to come back to really, you know, something that you guys could believe in, and you know, how did, I'm just kind of interested in and in understanding how did that conversation go, and who else might
we
come tomorrow?
We spoke with each other. We understand that this is it. For us, it's our last hurrah. And if we come together with our experience, with our knowledge, and even with the talent that we can bring to the squad, we knew we had to come back and set a foundation, set a standard for the younger ones, and just to, you know, help with the program being successful again. It went from going up in 2014 and just crashed 5 years.
Sean is over my shoulder here, but again, I must ask, you know, who might we see if we turn up to next month's camp?
Who might?
Yeah,
I honestly can't say. Who knows, you might see the one Kenya corner. So many others, players that you may not even have know, but we're just looking forward to come together as a team and just be around everyone and try and execute the coaches, our style of play and philosophy.
All the best, thanks again.
Thanks a lot.
You're good?